For each of us, there comes a moment. A defining instant in our lives. When we are changed forever.
Every week, thousands are drawn to Miami's aging Seaquarium for a spectacular encounter with a majestic creature of the deep.
Nice days, pretty colours. That's her name. Given to her by the coastal Salish people. Her name is Pocketeye, and that is what it means. Nice day, pretty colours.
I wish to make it known to our capital that there are many millions of people in this world that do not agree with anyone trying to make commercial gain out of captive animals, and in this case, Lolita. What happens when the seat's empty and the lights go out? What does she, as that daytime star, that performer, what does she think then? How has she coped with such stress in the quiet of the night, when the only sound for many hours are her own gentle blows as she gently breathes, and her own lonely heartbeats? Lolita has spent nearly 50 years performing now and earning the wealth of Miami Seaquarium. Earned a lot of money for that organization. Are you listening, folks? Okay, it is time to set her free. And of course, it is her captors that we need to convince. They are the people that must appreciate what the world is trying to do. We have had enough of it. Miami Seaquarium, a message for you. Enough is enough. Howard Garrett says, quote, the plan for Lolita is sound, and that park owners and government agencies will have to move with public opinion, and we might yet bring her home. If we achieve this, then, and only then, will she be called once again Pocketeye. Nice day, pretty colours. Thank you for listening.
Procedure. You have to capture them, separate them from their families, drag them literally kicking and screaming into these tanks, and their job for the rest of their life is to amuse an endless stream of people.
Free Lolita.
Free Lolita.
Free Lolita.
Lolita.
Free 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 Lolita.
She's simply surviving. There's a difference. Living is doing things. Living is chasing fish. It's cooperatively feeding. It's, moving around 100 miles throughout the day. That's what living is all about. She is simply surviving in this tank, and she's on death row. Lolita and other dolphins and whales are self-aware creatures. They routinely make choices and decisions regarding the details of their life. They are entitled to freedom of choice. Thus, Lolita is entitled to freedom. Capturing her and dragging her kicking and screaming into that concrete box is simply wrong. What a violation of nature, and what hypocrisy to say we're capturing these dolphins and bringing them to the Miami Seaquarium or SeaWorld or some other park so that we can teach you respect for nature.
So we would like to invite the Seaquarium and Arle Capital to talk to us, to find out how to go about helping her and helping yourselves at the same time. Thank you.
I understand Arle has strong corporate ethical standards. And as the fund managers for Candover's investments, I therefore ask you to please consider the wishes of thousands of people to help Lolita spend her remaining days in a more suitable environment. I ask you to please urge Palace Entertainment to work with Marine Connection and Orca Network to organize the proper retirement for Lolita. She's definitely earned it. Thanks.
Oh.